Well, joining us is the new Dundee Stars coach, Omar Pacha. Omar, firstly, how delighted are you to be signed up at the Dundee Stars?
Yeah, I'm really excited. I got the call yesterday morning, my time, and I had a few options back home, but when I was speaking to Steve Ward and, talking about the head coach position, but also the general manager position was really enticing for me. And, I've followed the Stars for the last few years now, and they've only done good things. And I just want to help the process and help them keep going upwards and grow the hockey side of it, but also the business side and grow the club and become a really established club in the league.
Yeah. Now, in terms of what your role will be at the Stars, for any fans that are confused or don't know, could you tell everybody what your actual role will be?
Well, speaking to Steve, obviously we're on the same page for a lot of things, but the role for me was just to come and obviously coach the team, recruit and everything, but help on the business side of things and help, be that face and that presence for the franchise and, help for anything off ice that I can assist with and to help the business grow as a general manager. Obviously with my years with, Neil Russell and Bobby and Hull, that was a position I was interested in. To be that person in charge of it, to help the business grow. And I think for the last few years that I have a passion for hockey, but I also have a passion of growing a business and growing a hockey team.
Yeah, you've mentioned that there, but the experience you had at Hull and, of course, in Manchester, in that role will probably be a real benefit to the Stars going forward.
Yeah, I hope so. I think it's a win-win situation. The Stars, get a guy that's willing to do a lot more than just the hockey side of things, but also for myself, it's a good experience to maybe look for an opportunity to grow myself as an individual in sport. And that's the main reason why it was so appealing, this opportunity, just because for myself, now I'm most likely not playing anymore. For me, it's all about the growth of the club. And I'm a big believer of the on ice product, but also growing the club, the organization, and doing everything I can to make the Stars a very healthy organization.
Yeah, now you touched on that there. Now, of course, at Manchester, you were a player coach. Will the Stars fans see you ice, or are you just going to be bench coach?
For now, with our discussions with Steve, we're looking more for a bench coach type of guy. A guy to take over the organization, have a management standpoint. So most likely to be the coach of the team and not playing. But you never know with hockey. You never know. So I don't want to set that door, and I don't want to leave that door kind of open. But for now, it's more of an opportunity for me to be behind the bench and oversee everything.
Yeah, now, in terms of your time at Manchester, of course, that came to an end in the summer. How disappointed were you that you didn't have a chance to continue on there at the time? Was it a disappointment?
Yeah, I don't want to really go into details because that's in the past, but I think it was just natural for everybody to move in a different direction. And obviously, it was disappointing, but it is what it is. That's the business in sports sometimes. So there's no need to dwell on the past. And now, like I said, I'm just excited about this the future with the Stars and this opportunity.
Yeah, no, of course, up to yesterday, everybody thought Mark Lefebvre was going to be the coach for the coming year, and there is players signed for the Stars for the coming season. What is the position in terms of that, Omar? Are you going to keep the roster that Mark has built so far and work with that, or are you going to have to speak to the guys and see if they still want to come? What's the situation?
Honestly, so early still, because I got the call yesterday, but for my standpoint, speaking to Steve as well, it's if the players are more than wanting to come and play for myself, I'll be willing to have them for the Stars, So I'm looking to keep the guys that we have signed up in place. Mark did a fantastic job so far building a really competitive team. So I think the philosophy, when I looked at every player, throughout the night last night, and I just feel there's a spot for everybody on the team. And And, you know, once a player signs a contract, I think it's important, or, you know, for anybody in an organization, when they sign a contract, you have to honor that. And for myself, at that standpoint, I'm going to honor everybody's contract. And there's going to be a spot for everybody that Mark signed on the team, because, as I said, I think it's a competitive club, and I just have to, you know, find the remaining pieces of the squad to make it a lot more competitive.
Yeah, in terms of next season, and what can fans expect in the coming weeks, Omar, in terms of signings? I know it's early days. I presume you'll have some idea of who you would have maybe looked at if you were at Manchester or that, and you can maybe bring some of these contacts in. But what can they expect in the coming weeks from yourself?
Well, for myself, obviously, there's players to finalize. There's a few spots up front. On the back end, we're looking at, there's a fast, aggressive, more of a north and south type of game that, you know, we focus a lot on the offense. And, you know, that speed and tenacity and skill set, a bit more skill set with the puck, and, you know, let's play a bit more offensive type of hockey. And that's what I love, and that's what I like. It's an exciting brand, sometimes a bit risky, but that's how I think we have more success at it.
Well, Omar, congratulations on signing with the Stars. We're all looking forward to seeing you at the start of the season, and I'm sure we'll be talking to you in the next few weeks as signings progress.
All right, sounds good. Thanks a lot.